بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده، أما بعد. Yesterday we started the chapter of the virtue to visit people of goodness, people of knowledge, to sit with them and to enjoy their company, to become part of their company. As we know and we hear often, the company of those that you keep is your company in the way that you act. And so in this chapter, Imam Nawawi rahimahullah, he mentions those ahadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged the Sahaba to make sure that those people that were around them were good people, people of piety, and encouraged them to always keep a good friend, a good companion with you. And if not so, then to go out and to look for good company and to sit with those who have knowledge. Yesterday we mentioned the hadith of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and Umar radiallahu anhu, both of whom after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, they would go and visit Umm Ayman. And Umm Ayman was a lady who took care of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And because she had taken the care of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam grew up in her lap. They found it virtuous to go and sit with a woman who knew the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for so long. And so they would go and they would visit her and sit with her and learn from her. And so for a person to go out and to sit with scholars, to go out and sit with people that are known for their righteousness and their piety, it's a means of trying to have that good righteousness and that piety rub off on ourselves as well. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, it's mentioned in the hadith and I read it here, I can't find it now. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam here, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would tell Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, ما يمنعك أن تزورنا أكثر مما تزورنا. He would ask Jibreel alayhi salam, oh Jibreel, why don't you visit me more? Because the companionship of an angel is a companionship of an angel. Angels are sinless, they are innocent, they do not commit any sins. Hence they have no sense of disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would want that Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam come more, and so that he could be in the company of Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. And so once Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam came down to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kind of complained, oh Jibreel, why don't you come more so that we can sit in your company more? The companionship of angels is blessed. We mentioned in Ramadan, angels are synonymous to rahmah, to mercy, to the dua of the angels. When a person is in the masjid, angels make dua for such a person. So Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam then said, وَمَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ لَهُمَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا وَمَا خَلْفَنَا وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ. And this is an ayah in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that they do not, or we do not let them come down, the angels do not come down except with the permission of Allah. So they're not at free will to even come down to earth. They only come down with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam was kind of telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, I can't come when I want, I only come with the permission of Allah. And the next hadith reported by Abu Musa Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam sets an example, a very beautiful example. إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الْجَلِيسِ الصَّالِحِ وَالْجَلِيسِ السُّوءِ كَحَامِلِ الْمِسْكِ وَنَافِخِ الْكِيبِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, you have a person in your company that's a good person. He's like a person who sells misk, perfumes, good fragrances. And a person who's a bad, you know, friend, or a person that may have a bad influence on you, he's like a blacksmith. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam then explained. He said, فَحَامِلُ الْمِسْكِ إِمَّا أَن يُحْذِيكَ وَإِمَّا أَن تَبْتَاعَ مِنْهُ. It's possible that the person who's selling perfumes or fragrances, it's possible you buy something from him. It's possible that just by being in the company of that person, he'll give you something. You know, you go to the store and there's perfume samples. You can spray it, you can smell it, you can take some. So even though you're not buying anything, you're just in the company of that person that's selling good fragrances, it's going to rub off on you. When you walk out of that store, you're going to smell good. You're going to have that smell of perfume on you. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person that's righteous, sitting in his company is just like that. It will rub off on you. You will automatically, while leaving his gathering or leaving his companionship, you'll feel it. You'll feel, oh subhanAllah, this person is so righteous. He does this, he does that. And it'll have an effect on you. It'll have an effect on the way you think. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person who is like a bad friend, or a person that may have a bad influence on you, he is like a nafikh al-kib, like a blacksmith. إما أن يحرك ثيابك وإما أن تجد منه ريحا متنطة. It's like sitting in the company of a blacksmith. Even though you may not do something exactly with the metal and with blowing the fire or with extinguishing the fire or doing whatever you may do nothing, just sit in his company. But sitting in his company, it might burn your clothes. It might even get some tar or some burnt on your clothes. And when you leave from that place, people will smell that you just came out from the blacksmith shop. And it will smell bad. So that's the example of having a bad friend or somebody that's bad influence on you. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam here is encouraging the Sahaba. And this is, you know, the Sahaba were grown men, not just for children, for adults as well. Keep good company, seek out the company of the pious and the righteous people. Spending time with them will definitely have an effect on the way we think, have an effect on our our conception of the our thinkings about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will definitely have a good influence on us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq to act upon what has been said. Subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.